Back in 2017, when I was just 16 years old, I was browsing YouTube when I stumbled across this video, making Minecraft in C++ and OpenGL from scratch. C++ and Minecraft were my biggest passions, so combining them would be a dream for me. But I needed to go from level 0 on OpenGL, all the way up to level 4 out of 5, at least if I wanted to finish this project. So I started with study first, and after that, I was ready to start learning OpenGL. That summer, during my holiday, I spent all my time doing OpenGL tutorials, one by one. Until eventually, I finally placed my first triangle on the screen. What I didn't know at that time is that I was only level 1 out of 5 at that point, with more difficulties to come at every step. But it didn't matter, because I wanted to make that project become a reality. So I pushed on, with every game I made, getting me closer to my final goal. So let's look at the 5 levels of OpenGL learning, see where you are right now, and I will give you some tips to get you to the next level. Starting with level 1. You have a triangle, but you don't understand shit. Congratulations, you placed your first triangle on the screen. This is your first ever OpenGL project. And at this point, you don't understand out of it. You have to spend like 3 days copying OpenGL code, setting up buffers, shaders and libraries, only to realize that you don't understand anything. But who cares, you have that dumb triangle. It was a hard battle, but you earned your well-deserved victory. You try to impress a girl with your triangle, but she asks what kind of buffers you used, and you have no idea what that even is. But that's okay, it was just a dream. You are not talking to girls in real life if you learn OpenGL. But if you are right now stuck at level 1, like you don't have a triangle or you have a triangle, but you don't understand anything, check out my course because it's specifically made to get you from 0 to level 2 in the most detailed and easy way possible, with challenges and quizzes to understand what all of these things do. Link in the description. But keep on learning, until eventually you get to level 2. You have a triangle, but you actually understand. Technically, you still have the same triangle on the screen, or maybe some very basic 3D thing, and you still don't talk to girls in real life. But now, you understand what's happening under the hood. You understand now how data is sent to the GPU, how a shader works, and how the OpenGL pipeline works. All that weird stuff that didn't make any sense, now is almost second nature to you, and it feels great. You really feel accomplished, like a big OpenGL weight was lifted off your shoulders. Don't get too excited, you still can do anything remotely useful with OpenGL. And 3D mess is still kinda scary. But on the other hand, because you actually understand what things do, you can get to practicing on your own. And very soon, you will get to level 3. Level 3. You can do 3D. This is the scariest part for most people. But right now, you just got past it, and it doesn't even seem hard anymore. And not only you finally understand 3D, but you actually have a mini game engine by now, with lighting, materials, maybe even some physics. Now, I know for a fact that if we look under the hood of that engine, we will see only OP crap, like every texture is a shared pointer, and you need 15 hierarchies of classes just to draw a single triangle on the screen. But let's not look at that. The important thing is that learning is super fun now. The 3D mess is satisfying now that you understand it, and the lighting is very cool to experiment with on your own. You can now complete some cool chapters in learnopengel.com. Lights and textures are easy. Normal maps or shadows are a little difficult, but who needs those anyway? If you spend a little more time, you can maybe add a skybox to your engine, and no one will notice how bad things look. But who cares how bad it looks? You have a 3D game, how awesome! And by now, you also stumbled across level 5 articles that look cool, but you absolutely have no idea what they mean. You still show them to your friends regardless, so you can look smarter than you are. But after a while, things are not fun anymore. All the easy chapters have been completed, so now only the hard tasks remain. Maybe you get lucky enough to stumble across this video made by a very smart guy that is totally not me, to get some more easy to implement ideas. But that only gives you 1 or 2 more days of coping, before you have to face your biggest fear. Implementing the not so easy stuff in OpenGL, like doing shadows, PBR or animations. The more you postpone that, the more you realize that's the only way to get to the next level. But one day, we'll finally start looking into these hard topics. And before you know it, you are at level 4, advanced OpenGL. This is where you basically can do OpenGL on your own. Things like normal maps are easy, shadows are still but you can at least implement them. And you even have PBR in your engine. There are so many cool things to do here, like different rendering, and look at these cool PBR materials that I have. But by far, the biggest marker of being level 4 in OpenGL is the fact that you can implement your own OpenGL algorithms without looking at any tutorial. I promise that I will eventually get to make Minecraft in C++. So I started to work on it. I needed a way to send data very fast to the GPU, and I came up with a solution to draw entire faces from a single vertex. I didn't know at the time, but this was called vertex pooling, and I implemented it all by myself. Or take a look at these guardrails. I tried searching online for tutorials, but I didn't understand. However, after chatting with ChatGPT a little about the subject, I realized that, bro, I can implement this myself today with no external help. Or take a look at these cool caustics that I have. I looked at how Minecraft caustics look. And then, I also searched online a little, until I found this video that shows how to fake caustics with a texture. So that's what I did. Isn't it cool? And I know things are hard, but you have all the resources online available. All you need to do is just spend the time, read them and try to implement them, even though it feels impossible at the moment. Maybe you even get lucky and stumble across the links in my Discord server, where I placed every good free OpenGL resource I know about. But this gets us to level 5, OpenGL God. At this point, everything you do happens in compute shaders, and these articles that you show to people to scare them, now you actually understand them, like the spherical harmonics article. These things are actually not that hard, and are used to very cheaply encode global ambient light. But what the f*** is this, bro? And I want to tell you an interesting story. Not too long ago, I met this guy who makes this very cool voxel game. Technically, he uses Vulkan, not OpenGL, but he's clearly a level 5 graphics programming god. The techniques and things he does are insane. This demo that you see runs at 120fps, rendering 18 quadrillion voxels. He has implemented both the ray tracing version and the classic rasterization version. And check this optimization out. Because blocks basically become one pixel at high distances, he draws them with a special compute shader that fills the screen pixel by pixel, rather than rasterizing them. This optimization was literally inspired by Nanite, literally the latest and probably the most complex optimization from a real engine. Or the geometry cooling that he has is insane. I can't even understand how it works. It somehow magically reduces the geometry to only the things that are visible, all in compute shaders, of course. Or for his global illumination implementation, he just basically found an implementation online, in another language. So he translated it, and integrated it into his project, and it just works. The funny thing is that he has been doing programming, and graphics programming for that matter, for less time than I did. But still he beats the crap out of me when it comes to graphics knowledge. And the reason is very simple, he just pushed himself more, that's it. I'm not gonna lie, for a long time, I was very afraid to get into compute shaders, or too lazy to learn them. Gabe, on the other hand, just got into them right away. Ray tracing? No problem, let's learn it. Vulkan? How hard can it be? Instead of being afraid of hard things, you should have a playful mentality towards them. Take them as a challenge that you can't wait to overcome. And let this be a reminder for you, that people that are way ahead of you are not necessarily special, but they just worked more than you, and they pushed harder than you on those hard things that you are too afraid to start learning. So if you want me to take you through the smoothest level 0 to level 2 journey possible, check out my OpenGL course in the description, or watch this video to finally start your OpenGL journey. See you there!